You're listening to the SWN podcast.
And this is SWN.
Welcome to SWN.
Skull! Skull! Skull!
This is SWN.
And this is the Scottish Wrestling Network.
Where Scottish wrestling lives, I guess. Is that a tagline? I guess. I don't know.
Hello and welcome to the SWN podcast. I am your host, as always, Billy. And yes, after 4 years of doing a podcast, and three of which where I've been doing like road trips, I have finally purchased an actual phone holder. So we're going to use it and head to the town hall. So I'm literally just recording. I'm outside my house because I thought this is just showing you. I think I've done this before in previous episodes, road trips to the town hall, how far away I am from this building. So I'm going to W3L Wrestling. No, it's not Wrestling Showdown. It's Summer Spectacular tonight at Elgin Town Hall. Doors opened about 10 minutes ago. Like I say, I am that close. I apologise for the vibrating. I'll see if I can stabilise that when I'm editing. But yeah, I'm looking forward to it. Three matches have been announced, one of which I'm super excited by, which is the W3L Heavyweight Championship match, which is Buffa defending against Luke King Sharp. I just watched Schools Out for Wrestling, so I'm kind of caught up already with the stories that are going on a little bit, to see the more contended matches that led to some of these matches. So I'm buzzing, absolutely buzzing, because, you know, I enjoy going to see wrestling. You know, I'm going to go see wrestling tonight. So I'm wearing my Blood Tourist t-shirt, my Luke King Sharp t-shirt, even though I know that he's a rotter at W3L. He attacked Buffa at Schools Out for Wrestling in Gala Shields on the 6th. But I'm going to go and support Lou anyway. Our two matches that have been announced for this show is the Breakout Championship that's been announced. Mayhem Brooks, Elgin Boy, has been announced. He will be defending his title against Jay the Jackal. I can't remember the last time I saw Jay wrestle, and it must have been 10 years ago, maybe? No, that's a lie, because he used to come up to Bucky for United Pro, United Pro Wrestling. So, I think, I'm sure he did, he definitely did. So, it's been a while since I've seen Jay wrestle anyway. It's been quite a number of years. Definitely. Never in Elgin, I don't think. So he'll be against Mayhem Brooks. Interesting combo. I'm just looking forward to seeing how that'll be. I'm very aware of how much vibrating is happening right now. I've stuck the thing to the window and I've realised how just like jittery it is. So good luck, Windows Movie Maker, to stabilise this. Another match that's been announced is Iron Drew Marshall taking on Hugo Harris. Should be good fun, because Iron Drew is good fan favourite when he comes up to Elgin. Every time I've seen him wrestle in Elgin, he gets a proper good reaction, and he's taking on Hugo Harris. I've seen Hugo wrestle a few times for W3L. Just a very impressive athlete. He's just not in as many places that I cover for the podcast and for the website itself. Convertible. I've just. So I could have went right and I'd been waiting for ages, or went left roundabout with him. I'm on. So the boy was next to me in the convertible has been waiting a little bit longer, and he's just got out now and I've already whizzed round and I'm way ahead of him. So that's three matches that have been announced for W3L at Elgin Town Hall tonight. I'm just about there. I've just got like a roundabout and a left turn and a right turn and then a right turn and then I'm parked. So it's that is how close this venue is. You know, I could probably walk it. Jesus, bloody bus. G4's coming to Elgin. Jesus. So yeah, there's it's not a very long episode, these ones, generally, because I'm there pretty much. And there's a good queue. That's good. And the doors have actually opened. My God, we could be on time for things tonight. I'm very excited about that prospect, because the last few years it has ended up being there's been electrical issues, there's been late openings, and all that kind of stuff. So this is, I think this might be the first year in about three maybe four, that it's actually opened up on time. Well, I say on time, it opened up 15 minutes ago and I'm just arriving now. And here I am. So yeah, it's a very big road trip. Takes me less than 5 minutes to get to the venue itself. And here I am, Elgin Town Hall. I will do a little, there's the venue on my way over. And I'm going to go see some W3O wrestling. So always interesting doing these particular podcasts. I'll try and do a little detour on the way home. And then it'll be the in-studio bit, which I'll record on Friday, because this is Thursday. Thursday the 25th of July? July? I've got a sneeze I'm trying to hold in. So next bit should be montage, probably. Very quick, pacey episode. We'll be in the back half and doing the review before you even know it. So for now, enjoy the montage. I can't believe I'm going to the montage in less than 10 minutes. But anyway, right. Enjoy. I'll see you in about, I don't know, 5 minutes or so. We'll say that. Yeah, I don't know. We'll see how it goes. There's the town hall in the distance. In a very, well, not that far away. The queue is moving. The queue is moving. I repeat, the queue is moving. So I'm going to go and join it. And get a little bit of air because I am absolutely boiling. It is 21 degrees in this car and I am wearing a black t-shirt. I have chosen poorly, but I've got to support Luke King Sharp because he's just ace. So anyway, right, next bit, probably the montage. Let's do this. So there we are. We are finished. We are out of the show. It is absolutely pissing down rain now, and it's 15 degrees. So we did this exercise, it was 21 degrees, boiling hot, and now here I am, what is it, 3 hours? 3 hours later? Absolutely chucking it down. What a night. What a night at the town hall. This has been an absolute blast of a show. Like, top to bottom, 5 matches, 5 great matches, and a bit of chaos. The crowd were loud. The crowd really wanted to see some wrestling, and they bloody got some wrestling. It was just a really great night. Great night. I didn't hang about too long. I was expertly marched out by Sammy Sparks as he conversed with me about other things, about Border Pro and what have you. And suddenly I found myself outside, and there I was. I thought, oh, I'm outside. There I was. So it was a really, really top to bottom solid show. Actually, not even, it's better than solid. It was a bloody banging show, and we got to see some great action. I mean, from the starting match, which was Sammy Sparks versus Xander Davidson, that was an absolute cracker of a match. The second match was, oh, my brain is just short-circuited because I cannot remember. Mark Monroe versus Logan Smith, that's what it was. Really, really, like, I can't remember the last time I saw Logan Smith. It must have been a while ago. Anyway, so it was great to see Logan Smith. Mark Monroe, unfortunately, had the disadvantage of being the de facto bad guy, even though he was trying to, like, get high fives and clap hands and everything. And the fans were just like, Nah, we're not doing that. I think it's because some of them may have remembered, I think last time they were there in the town hall anyway, that Mark Monroe was a bad guy. So why would cheer him? But he tried his best. He tried his best to get some cheers going, but generally it was mostly for Logan Smith on that particular match. First off, main was Mayhem Brooks against the Jackal. Brooks got a tremendous ovation. The people were here to see Mayhem Brooks, and they loved seeing Mayhem Brooks, which is another really, really good match, a really solid match. Ended in submission. I got play clips of a lot. Annoying thing was, I kind of, for some of the clips, I cut off just before like the really cool bit, so I got the kind of like build up bit, the foreplay to the move, so to speak, and I missed the big move. So you have to check out Summer Spectacular on demand on, no, was it On Demand Progress? Progress on Demand. I should know, the ad ran 3 times, I think. Demand Progress Plus, that's what it's called. Yeah, so there's some really, really cool stuff. Back from the interval. The interval was long because so many people wanted to get pictures with Mayhem. So many people wanted to actually get a picture with Mayhem Brooks in the ring, with the belt, with the breakout belt. Which is testament, I think, this was a fantastic crowd for W3L. Sometimes it could be a bit wishy-washy with people that arrive. Sometimes the crowd isn't as big, depending on when they do it. But this was an absolute banger. A banger crowd, a banger match, a banger show, just in general. It was a great night at W3L. So back from the break, we got Hugo Harris versus Iron Drew Marshall. We've got some bits. I'm sure these guys faced each other at the Bishopville Hall at some point, because I'm sure I remember there's a spot where kids helped do the low blow bit the Drew Marshall did. I'm sure that was Hugo Harris, but I could be absolutely misremembering it. But regardless, another great match on the show. I really enjoyed Hugo Harris. I think if he went to other places, I think Hugo Harris has got the same kind of upper trajectory as likes of Jack Morris, you know? It just depends. It's just where he wants to go, where he wants to apply his trade, I suppose, for those opportunities to open up to him. And then the main event was Buffa AO taking on Luke King Sharp, and this was absolute chaos. Once again, I thought we avoided it. The match had ended. Luke King Sharp went to the back with his dungarees still on. Yet he still came back out, took his dungarees off, and tried to start a dance off. And so, once again, I think this was his four years in a row, Luke King Sharp has ended his match, or ended the night in Elgin, with his pants. I don't know what it is about Elgin, that seems to make looking sharp decide I'm taking off my clothes. But, you know, it's hilarious. It's hilarious. I met a few people during the show that I know, and some people are coming to their first show, the first ever wrestling show, and they were enjoying it. So that's always good. It's always good when people are coming to their first show and they're actually enjoying it, because I always feel like, because I do the podcast, I do the website and everything like that, I get worried that maybe I'm over like bigging up wrestling in this country, and bigging up the shows and bigging up the wrestlers. So when I see people come to these shows, I know maybe it's their first show and they enjoy it, I'm like, that's fine, I'm doing the right thing here, I'm actually promoting some decent, some entertaining wrestling as well. And with that, that's me driving, as we turned right into my driveway. Driveway sounds really fancy. I've got a parking space. Oh, and I've just hit the curb. Wonderful. But no, this has been an absolute. I'll do a post show thing in the studio tomorrow on Friday, and I'll get this put up onto Patreon. I think we're going to make the montage again. I'm going to make it through the iPhone thing, iMovie, because that really worked last time for Community Pro, so I'm going to try that again. I've got loads of clips though, so keep an eye on YouTube, on our shorts and stuff like that. I'm going to put some on there as well. But a fantastic night for W3L. Didn't get any meets, didn't do any, didn't hang about too long. I didn't stay around for the meet and greet afterwards, where I chanced my luck and not pay for the backstage pass, but end up backstage. Sophie as well. That was great seeing Fee, she's lovely. But no, it's just a really, and Amelia as well for Border Pro. So I got to see a lot of people that I know. I had a good time. I had a good night at W3L. Their next show is November 29th at Bishop Mill Hall. I will have to see if I'm going to go to that one, because that is Kelly's birthday. Birthday is on the Friday, or would be the Friday, or it'll be the 28th. And so I will have to see if we can go on the 29th, and maybe it'll be me and Jack's second show. So anyway, that was a really dodgy break there. Sorry, I had to sneeze again because I've got just the worst hay fever. But I don't take tablets, so it's my own fault. But anyway, I'm definitely logging off at this point. It's only like an extra second or two. But I had a great night at W3L. Back to the studio, and let's see what a night's sleep Billy thinks about this and thinks about the show itself. I'm sure his opinion will be exactly the same, and I'll probably think of more stuff about the show itself. But for now, back to the studio. How did you like the show, Billy?
Several days later.
Hello again, we're back in the studio here at SWN Towers, aka my office. It's been a couple of days, so I'm recording this on the 29th of July. I was supposed to record it over the weekend. I haven't done that, but you know, here we are anyway. It was been a great show from W3L. So I did the write-up. It's on SWN website now. For those that want to watch the show back, it will be available soon on W3L box office events via Demand Progress Plus. It's on there. And Billy, a moment ago, it was a great show. That's my overall arching thought about it, really, because there's five matches on the show. But I would take five really good matches over six, seven, or eight matches where some of them were just rubbish, really. So I had a good time. I had a good time at WCL on Thursday. Just quick results. Sammy Sparks defeated Xander Davidson. Logan Smith defeated Mark Monroe in a breakout championship match. Mayhem Brooks retained over Jay the Jackal. Hugo Harris defeated Iron Drew Marshall. And in the W3L Heavyweight Championship match, Buffa retained against Looking Sharp. And we had a dance-off at the end of the night. Yeah, it was just a fantastic night. It's probably, like, I think I said this in the write-up as well. I may have said it a couple of minutes ago. But this has been, that was the best W3L show I've seen top to bottom, I think, since I started going. And that was, 2012 was the first time I went to a W3L show in Elgin. And it was probably the best show that I've seen from them top to bottom. I mean, the Summer Spectacular they did, which had Doug Williams versus Taylor Bryden, that was a pretty solid show. But this one, I think five great matches, absolutely great matches that provided a lot of entertainment, helped that the crowd were super into it. They wanted to see some wrestling and they got it. They got to see some entertainment. They got to be they got to do some yay booing. They got to attack Hugo Harris and ram his nuts into the ring post. It got to laugh at Liu Kang Sharp as he undressed again in Elgin. So this was an absolute, like, I don't even think I can, I don't do ratings or anything like that, 5-star ratings or anything like that. I just tell you how I enjoy the match. Kind of, it's what we do here. Why do anyway, SWM. But I think there was very little, if any, faults I could think of. I'm trying to think of some, but I can't. I just really enjoyed this show. It was an absolute blast. So hopefully that comes across when the footage comes out on Demand Progress Plus. That this had 5 really good matches, really heated matches, and really entertaining matches that we enjoyed in Elgin at the Elgin Town Hall. So what we do know is they're coming back, WTL coming back in November in Elgin, which is November 29th, I think it is, which is a Friday. We'll be able to swing that to go to that with possibly Kelly, most probably Jack as well. So we'll go to that, hopefully, unless we've got something planned around about that time and I'm not in Elgin at the time. But no, fantastic. Great work. I don't want to labour on too long. It's a nice quick episode of the SWN podcast, because otherwise I'm just going to go over and over again, repeating the same points over and over. If you want my full write-up, my full thoughts, you've got the initial, you've got the pre-show and the post-show, initial bang on, that's the thoughts I had before and after the show. If you want to, the thoughts that I wrote down after, I wrote down the correct phrasing to put that, I don't know. Anyway, if you want to read my review of the show, go to swnscotland.com and you can go check it out there. But for those that are listening to this early, thank you for listening to this on Patreon for your whole £1 and VAT. So I think that's £1.20. For those that aren't listening on Patreon and listening to normal places, you can get all the access to first listen to episodes on SWN, patreon.com/scottresnet. It's £1 plus VAT. That's it. That's all it costs to join. And you get the episodes, you get the audio episodes pretty much the day after, day of, depending on when I actually record it. And so you get them as soon as possible. And you get the announcements of who's coming on the podcast as soon as possible. I think sometimes that does go a little bit awry when I'm getting someone so quick. So if I've got someone and I'm recording that day or the next day, some updates get a little bit slower. But generally, you get a full lineup and scope of who we've got coming on the podcast as soon as possible. So go check that out. Well, thank you for joining us at SWN, at this podcast. We're doing great things. I'm looking forward to seeing what else we do this year as we march towards 300 episodes of the podcast. Thank you for listening. Check us out on all the platforms, on YouTube, which if you're watching the video, that's where you're watching it now, or on Spotify, Apple Podcasts, and swnscotland.com for everything else. But no, this will be Billy. I won't hang around too long here. Thank you for watching this very quick episode of the SWN podcast. Have a good day, stay hydrated, etc. I haven't thought of an outro, still haven't. We're almost 300 episodes. This is a terrible look on me. But no, have a good time. Good one.